The South has given the nation much of its music. America has been blessed by the infusions of many Southern-derived styles of music, from blues, gospel and jazz, to country and rock and roll. And each has its own special features. The musical heritage of the South was developed by both whites and blacks, both influencing each other directly and indirectly. The South's musical history actually starts before Civil War, with the songs of the African slaves and the traditional folk music brought from Britain and Ireland. Blues was developed in the rural South by African Americans in the late 19th century.
The blues, as it developed slowly and piecemeal amongst former slave communities in the USA in the final decades of the 19th century, clung resolutely to the flattened thirds and sevenths, and does so to the present day. Indeed, they became known as blue notes. Blue notes, revivalist spirituals, the call and response or holler songs of the Deep South, all derived from their African origins, went into the mixing pot of the early blues. But also mixed in were chords borrowed from hymns and parlor and vaudeville songs, and the folk songs of other members of the American underclass.
Baby, you never.
There's been considerable research into song forms of the poorest Americans of all ethnic groups in the 19th century. It reveals the influence of Anglo-Celtic folk music on the growth of the blues. This folk music was learnt from the African Americans' co-workers in the cotton fields and on the railroads, many of whom were from the British Isles. Amongst these song types are hundreds which lament the burden and misery of the labourer's life.
Jazz is a distinctive style of music derived from blues in the early 20th century. It is characterized by swing and blues, call and response, polyrhythms and improvisation.
From the very beginning, jazz as a style eluded definition, so various were its manifestations in different places. It's hardly surprising that a genre which defied form, which chose improvisation over the printed page, which allowed maximum freedom and looseness in its harmony, its interpretation of melody and its rhythm, should have splintered into 100 colourful shards on impact with the world. In the 20s and 30s, the records of Louis Armstrong, Fats Waller, Duke Ellington and many others were eagerly listened and danced to across the world. But there was another aspect to jazz that set a tone for popular music in the 20th century. From its earliest days, it appeared to belong equally to musicians of all races, bucking the segregated trend of 20s and 30s society.
Although jazz has roots in African-American music traditions, including blues and ragtime, it is also highly connected to European military band music. Typical instruments are, for example, piano, saxophone, trumpet, and guitar. In contrast to blues and jazz, gospel music didn't use those kinds of instruments. It is a genre in Christian music that can be traced to the early 17th century with roots in the black oral tradition. The term gospel song probably appeared in 1874. Gospel music usually has dominant vocals, often with strong use of harmony, and Christian lyrics. In the churches where gospel music was sung, most of the singing was done a cappella. Hand clapping and foot stomping were used as rhythmic accompaniment.
Let my people go. Pressed so hard they could not stand.
Let my
Another music style that originated in the southern United States is country music, which was brought up in the 1920s.
Howdy, friends. Welcome to the Grand Ole Opry, the capital of country music throughout the world. Let her go, boys!
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on.
They used to call it hillbilly music. It was the sound of the working class in forgotten corners of the southern states of America as they tried to scratch a living off the land.
We were those people back in the mountains, and we lived so hard. Every day was struggle.
One of the sort of fundamental ingredients of country music is this sense of home. So you hear a lot of wonderful songs about Texas, Tennessee, the Carolinas.
And you put people on the land trying to make a living in a very harsh environment at that time, and you get white blues, which is country music.
The songs and the musical instruments were from a distant time and place, but the people who made this music would take it all with them on a thrilling and dangerous ride through the 20th century. In no time at all, this strange hillbilly sound would be transformed into country music that would speak to the world.
Country music often consists of ballads and dance tunes with generally simple forms and harmonies, accompanied by mostly string instruments, such as banjos, electric and acoustic guitars, dobros, fiddles, as well as harmonicas. According to Lindsay Stans, the term country music gained popularity in the 1940s in preference to the earlier term hillbilly music. The term country music is used today to describe many styles and subgenres. The origins of country music are the folk music of working-class Americans who blended popular songs, Irish and Celtic fiddle tunes, traditional English ballads and cowboy songs, and various musical traditions from European immigrant communities. Finally, rock and roll originated from all those southern music styles in the late 1940s and early 1950s. While elements of rock and roll can be heard in blues records of the 1920s and in country records of the 1930s, the genre didn't acquire its name until the 1950s.
Rocket 88 was released in 1951. It's generally reckoned to be the first rock and roll record. Unlike the unpredictability of bebop, rock and roll's appeal lay in the clockwork rigidity of four beats to a bar. Jazz was for cool dudes to listen to, rock and roll was for teenagers to dance and date to. And teenagers suddenly existed, apparently, after 1950.
V8 motor and this smart and designed black convertible top and the gals don't mind. Sporting with me riding on.
Not only did teenagers now exist, the affluent society that was America and eventually Europe in the post-war period saw teenagers with pocket money to spend. Transistor radios and Dansett record players meant that music aimed at teenagers was where the money was to be made, and the record business acted accordingly. Increasingly, albums were made for adults, singles in the hit parade were squarely aimed at youth.
All those great music styles were either born or developed in the southern United States. And whether you like to listen to them or not, they had a huge influence on all kinds of music all over the world, as well as on the music we listen to today.